There was a Asura who had the capacity to emanate a lot of heat.
Analasura.
And the word anal means heat, extreme heat. In one of the legends, it's that Ganesha had sort of devoured the Asura.
So he vanquished him by devouring him.
Devouring him.
And which is why he was very hot.
Tapa. So he became very hot. To cool him down, what the devotees saw
the devas brought this particular grass,
which was there,
and kept it on his head, and that cooled him down. It's very interesting how they have used the word seer for our rishi. Rishis in English are called seers because they really saw far beyond what we are seeing with our eyes. They saw much beyond, and they have tried to give it forms and symbolism. So this symbolism of offering this grass, Ganesha devouring this anala, heat, and all of this asura and all of this, it is actually portraying so much more. And to understand what we are really portraying is where we need masters like Sri Aurobindo and so many others who have come in this hoary tradition of India, of this land, to guide us to understand this symbolism. Otherwise, we get caught in the ritual. We'll get caught in just plucking the grass and offering it and not really understanding why we are doing it, how we should therefore shape our lives going forward. So it's very, very important to get guided on understanding these kind of symbolism, get to the deeper core of what our ancestors have tried to tell us through these various stories, these legends, and some of these usual traditions and rituals.
So this particular grass is an Ayurvedic remedy. When the body gets ushna, ushna is heat. So there is this particular, it's like a decoction, what you call as kashayam in Ayurveda.
Today it is often had, the juice of that grass is also drunk by people.
By people to sort of soothe the body, cool the body down. So look at that. What it is used in Ayurveda, to what you give it to Ganesha, again, it very well tallies.
So something for your body, something for your mind. So as a ritual, it's for your mind and to make you more aware. Also as a juice, it does bring in the same kind of benefit to your body too.
It's a big coolant. So when you go for so many coolants today, sharbats, we have forgotten to have this particular coolant to the body, which is a natural coolant. Today you put coolant inside a car for the car not to get heated up.
But we forget about ourselves.
That is inanimate. This is animate. This body is animate. We can use this coolant to cool ourselves. So if the body is cool, the mind is also cool. When the body is heated, mind is heated.